Rudolph Giuliani, born in Brooklyn, became our mayor. We all know the background of his fighting crime and his success at making New York a better place to live. He went against the grain a little bit and started, the quality of life for the people in this city. He fought very hard for that, and kind of seemed like all the people on the street and the people accosting you to do this or that seemed to go away. And it made this city a whole lot better place, but no one knew what was going to happen on September 11th. And I don't know if anybody stood up and made us proud to be a part of New York City more than Rudy Giuliani during that period, and I mean that. He was great. He gave us pride. He made us feel safer. And he has a few words to say tonight. He was sorry he could not be here, but he did record this video for us. Could we have that, gentlemen?
Good evening. I'm very sorry that I can't be with you tonight because the fund is, I believe, one of the most important institutions, one of the most important organizations in New York City. First, I want to thank Rusty Staub and Steve Danhauser for all of the work that they've done in establishing the fund and keeping it going. This organization, for 25 years now, has been at the backbone of supporting our police officers and firefighters and supporting their families. And everyone realizes when we lose a firefighter or a police officer how important it is that we stand with them, that we support them. But this fund that was started by Rusty and Steve now 25 years ago is right there to give that support, to make sure that families understand in their time of great loss that they're not alone, that the community that their loved ones have given their lives to serve is there with them, and that they will be taken care of, that their children will be taken care of, that at least this material part of their loss can be dealt with and compensated. After September 11, 2001, I think everyone in New York City and everyone in the country realized the value of public service, of uniform service, of what firefighters and police officers do for us, because on that day it was so dramatically demonstrated to us with the loss of so many of them. But day in and day out, police officers and firefighters put their lives at risk for us. I grew up in a family of five police officers and a firefighter. My uncles were firefighters and police officers. And I realized, from the time I can remember growing up in Brooklyn, the tremendous pressure on their families, that at any time they left for work, whether it was in the morning or the afternoon or the evening, they might not come back that night. I remember the pressure whenever there was a shooting or a terrible fire that it might be their loved one, my uncle, their father, husband, son, that wasn't the one to return. I can remember some very serious injuries to my uncle who was a firefighter. A little boy, I used to go to Kings County Hospital with my mother to visit him, and his tremendous desire to go back to work even though he had been very seriously injured. These are pressures that exist in the families of firefighters and police officers. They need to know, in order to do their jobs, they need to know that their families are going to be taken care of. They need to know that if, God forbid, the thing that happened to their colleague or their friend, if that happens to them, that their families will be taken care of in a very special way. And the fund makes sure that that happens. Immediately, a family receives a $25,000 check, then every year a $13,000 check. And they receive not just money, which is really important, I'm not minimizing that, but they also receive emotional support and people who have gone through the same thing that they've gone through, which is so important when you go through a crisis. The thing about what Rusty and Steve have been able to accomplish here is not just support at a time when something is in the headlines or very dramatic like September 11 was, or some of the terrible shootings or loss of firefighters we have, but they're there all the time. They're there at every occasion that this happens, the famous ones and the ones that don't get the attention. I can remember being at the bedside of police officers and firefighters, wondering whether they were going to make it or not, realizing that they hadn't, and then knowing that just one of the few things you could do was give them the material support that gave their family some sense of solidity. So what the fund does is vitally important to keeping a city safe, to keeping a city decent, and ultimately keeping a city compassionate and able to fulfill its promises to the people who put their lives at risk. So all of you have to contribute. You have no choice. This is the way in which you pay back the people who keep you and your family safe in the most important way in which you can help them. So be there for them, make sure that you contribute, and I know the times are difficult right now, but this is exactly the time when you have to reach in and give a little bit more. Again, congratulations to everyone connected with this wonderful organization, in particular to Rusty and Steve. Thank you, and God bless you.